We ended up riding little motor scooters around that we found. And I found a little motor scooter, and I got a little time off. So I thought, I'm gonna go for a ride on my motor scooter. The motorcycle went plop, 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 boom, quit. Here I am out in the middle of nowhere. I had no weapon with me, and there were still a bunch of weirdos running around, the poor losers and that kind of stuff, you know. And I thought, man, golly, you're dumb, Roger. What are you? Now you're stuck out here. And while I tried to push it, and it would pop a little bit, and I'd try to jump on, but I couldn't do everything at once to make it work. So I needed a push. And here I look down the road, and here comes a guy walking around the corner. I could see he was from Belsen concentration camp. And I could see his uniform, and it was striped with a little yellow star. And it was so dirty, it wasn't really white and black stripes, it was brown and black. And he was so skinny, I didn't know how he could even walk. I motioned to him what I needed done, and he figured it out right away. And he was anxious, so anxious to help me. He gave me a push, and the motorcycle started. And I looked back, and what a smile. Oh, he gave me the most beautiful smile. I see that smile every day. I'm so glad. He's so glad to be free. So glad to be able to help somebody. You know, later on, I thought about him, and I thought, how come he was so happy? He didn't know where his next meal was coming from. He didn't know if his people were still alive. All the things he didn't know was amazing. But he knew one thing. He knew he was free.
The War, Nebraska Stories, inspired by our greatest generation.